continue with this story, and that is not working. So again, like, you know, this now Ratna stood. So as I told you, you know, that girl Ranga's you know, the author, she wanted to fix Ranga with a girl because she thought that Ranga is the, you know, best most eligible bachelor in the village. So she tried to hook him up with a girl of her choice, and she called up the girl at her place, and the girl started singing, and she called up for Ranga also, and he also reached there, and he just saw the girl, he heard her song, and he was kind of like, you know, head over heels. Now, you know, it was my coming. Ratna stood at a distance. Now you sent for me, he asked as he came in and sat on a chair. Now he said, you call me, and you know, that's why I've come here. Now Ratna stood at a distance. Ratna stood at a distance and her head lowered. Ranga repeatedly glanced at her. Glance means looked at her. Once our eyes met and he looked very embarrassed. So like, you know, he kind of was little embarrassed. No one spoke for a while, you know, that odd silence, I mean, you know. Now, it was my coming in that stopped the singing. Let me leave. He said, I think she has stopped singing because I just barged in. So let me leave. Words, mere words. The fellow said he would leave but still did not make a move. Like, you know, he just said it but he did not want to leave because he was, as I told you, head over heels. Now how can one expect words to match actions in these ways of Kali Yuga? The author is saying obviously this Kali Yuga is time when your words do not match with your actions. Now Ratna ran inside, overcome by shyness. That girl felt a little shy and, like, you know, she went inside. Sorry. Okay, she went inside. Now after a while, Ranga asked, who is that girl, Swami? Now who is that inside? The lion wanted to know. The he-goat who had taken shelter in the temple replied, does it matter who I am? I'm a poor animal who has already entered 9 lions. I have vowed to eat one more. Tell me, are you male or female? The lion fled the place in fear, it seems. So this is a story, actually. You know, this story is about a lion, and lion asked, you know, who's inside the cave? And there was a he-goat, actually. It is an example, okay, guys? This is an example. The he-goat had taken a shelter in the temple, and she replied, does it matter who I am? I'm a poor animal who has already eaten 9 lions, and I have vowed to eat one more. And she said, you know, I just want to eat one more lion. Tell me, are you male or female? And the lion fled the place in fear. And lion thought that, oh my god, such a terrible species of animal, and he just fled, you know, the place. So like the he-goat, I said, what does it matter to either of us who she is? I'm already married, and you are not the marrying kind. 1 minute. Now, very hopefully he asked, she isn't married then? His voice did not betray his excitement, but I knew it was there. Now he said, is she not married? His voice, like, you know, it did not betray his excitement, but I knew it was there. Now, she was married a year ago. I said she was married a year ago. Then his face shriveled like a roasted brinjal, like he felt very bad. And after a while, Rana left saying, I must go. I have some work at home. Now I went to our Shastri the next morning, and I told him, keep everything ready to read the stars, I'll come later. I told Shastri that, you know, you just keep everything ready, like, actually before marriage we read some stars, the horoscope and the natal chart, no? And I said, I'll come later. I tutored him in all that I wanted him to say. I tutored means I said all the things which I wanted him to say the next day. I found no change in Ranga when I met him that afternoon. What's the matter? You seem to be lost in thought, I said. Nothing wrong.